In this video, we will give an overview of the sample design for understanding society and how to account for it in analysis. Understanding Society is a household panel survey which started in 2009. Every year, information is collected about members of the sampled households. Sample members are still eligible for interviews even when they move. So why do we have different samples in the study? The answer is that this is a multi-purpose study, and the aim was to allow a wide range of research using this data. First, the sample needed to be large enough to allow analysis of minority samples, for example, single mothers and disabled persons. Second, it needed to have a wide geographic coverage to allow researchers to compare regional differences. Third, the sample needed to have sufficiently large numbers of ethnic minority and immigrant sample members to allow longitudinal ethnicity and migration research. Fourth was to allow longitudinal analysis over a long duration. And to achieve these aims, the sample was designed and selected as follows. There are four subsamples which were designed to achieve the aims we just discussed. We'll talk about these one at a time. The general population sample, or GPS, consists of approximately 24,800 households from Great Britain and around 2,000 households from Northern Ireland. It is intended to be representative of the UK population in 2009 to 2010, but addresses in Northern Ireland were chosen with twice the selection probability as compared to the Great Britain part. The large sample size allows analysis of small populations, and the large sample spread across the UK allows for geographical analysis. The higher selection probability for the Northern Ireland part was to allow a Northern Ireland sample that was large enough to allow country-level analysis. The Great Britain part had a clustered and stratified design, with addresses being chosen from the small address postal address file, and the Northern Ireland part had a simple random sample design. The ethnic minority boost sample contains around 4,000 households with at least one ethnic minority individual. It was designed to allow longitudinal analysis of ethnicity and migration-related issues. The target was to survey at least 1,000 adults in each of the following groups: African, Bangladeshi, Caribbean, Indian and Pakistani groups, plus 1,000 from all mixed backgrounds, as well as Chinese, other Asian and Middle Eastern. To manage the costs, sampling was restricted to areas in Great Britain where the ethnic minority concentration was greater than 5%. That was approximately 35% of all areas in Great Britain and covered more than 80% of the five key ethnic group populations in Great Britain. The British Household Panel Survey is another household panel survey which started in 1991 and continued until 2008. It was decided to include respondents from this survey who were still active in 2008 into Understanding Society to allow research of long-term change. The BHPS sample comprises four samples. All of these had a clustered and stratified design except for the Northern Ireland boost sample, which was a simple random sample. Addresses in the Scottish, Welsh and Northern Ireland boost samples had a higher selection probability than addresses in the original sample. In the sixth wave of Understanding Society, an immigrant and ethnic minority boost sample was added. This was to account for the population changes in the UK since wave one, and to allow for ethnicity and immigration-related longitudinal research. The target was to have 2,500 adult interviews from the five key target ethnic minority groups, as in the EMBS, and 2,000 immigrants, allowing for some overlap between the two. As in the EMB, the sample was selected from high ethnic minority and immigrant concentration areas in Great Britain. The discussion of the samples until now pertained to how addresses were selected. After that, at each selected address, as long as it was a residential address and was occupied as the main residence, up to three dwelling units were selected. For example, if the address was an apartment building, a dwelling unit refers to an apartment. But if the address was a house, that would just be one dwelling unit. If there was more than one household at each dwelling unit, which was not very common, up to three are randomly selected. All household members in each selected household became part of the sample. So what does this mean when using the data? Don't use design samples to select individuals for analysis, apart from the BHPS sample. This is because some of these samples, like the boost samples, are not selected from the whole population, so your estimates will suffer from coverage error. You can select samples in other ways, e.g. all people of one ethnic group, all women, all employed people. Remember, data from different samples are not provided in separate files, so if you don't actively do anything, you will be using all samples together. Some sections of the population are overrepresented in these samples. For example, households in Northern Ireland, some ethnic minority groups. So any estimate based on the whole sample will be biased in favour of these overrepresented groups. Use weights, which are designed to correct for this. There is a separate video on how to use weights. Not all samples are simple random samples, which is what all statistical softwares assume. So, standard error estimates produced by these softwares will be incorrect, unless you specify the survey design variables, strata and PSU, when computing standard errors. The exact method will vary by software. To know more about the sample design and weights, you can refer to the user guides listed here, and the working papers listed here. Thank you for watching. You can find more useful videos on our website, understandingsociety.ac.uk. Follow us on Twitter, email the user support team at the email address here, or sign up for our newsletter.